Hello, statisticians. Mr. Young Saber here from Skewed the Script. Have you ever wanted to go to Vegas and try and make money gambling at the casino tables? Well, today we're going to be looking at the expected values of casino games, and we're going to see how hard that can be. Let's skew it. Today's lesson is on random variables and expected value. This is lesson 5.5 in our course sequence. And we're going to start today at the fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada, a place I've visited multiple times with my friends. And I have a friend of mine, a dear friend named John. He has this roulette strategy. He swears works. He says, I got a system for roulette that works, plays video roulette, person roulette. And we tested this out at the casinos. So one time we went on a Vegas trip, me and some of my friends, we all started with a net zero gains, zero losses. And here were our winnings or losses at the end of our time. Nelson, good friend of mine, lost $30, unfortunately, by the end of the trip. Not so bad. Elliot made $10 by the end of the trip, so he did pretty well. My friend Sean lost $120. And my friend John, the one with the roulette strategy, lost $375 that trip. However, I, statistician who knows probability and expected values, well, I'm going to tell you my story at the end of our time together today in this video. And we're going to talk about specifically, is there a way to beat the casinos at their own games in Vegas? And we're going to talk about roulette in particular. This is lesson 5.5. If you all follow along using our handout, you can go to this URL to print it up and follow along. First, we're going to talk about discrete random variables, and we're going to build up to talking about the casino games themselves. Now, let's talk about roulette. Roulette is a game where they have the spinning wheel and there are different spaces with numbers and colors. There are specifically 18 black spaces, 18 red spaces, and one green space on the European roulette tables. And if you bet on a certain color and the ball that spins around lands on that color, you get money. You won your bet. So let's pretend that we bet on black. So we bet that the ball is going to land on one of the black squares. Let's make a random variable, X equals the winnings from a $100 bet on black. So X, the random variable, can take on two values. Either we win the $100 we bet or we lose the $100 we bet. And we can find probabilities for each of those values. The probability that we win the $100 we bet is the probability that it lands on black. The ball lands on one of the black squares. That's 18 out of 37 total squares. So there are 18 black squares out of 37 total spaces, which is about 48.6% chance. Now, probably we lose the 100 is the 18 red spaces plus that one pesky green space all divided by 37. So that's 19 out of 37 ways that it won't land on a black square and we lose our money. That's a 51.4% chance. So let's talk about the difference between this random variable we just created and what we call a regular variable in algebra and math generally. So in a regular variable, we have, say, an equation we need to solve for. We subtract 2 from both sides in this case, and we solve that x equals 3. A regular variable just represents a constant number that is real, but we don't know it yet. And we need to solve for it using algebra. A random variable is very different. A random variable, capital X, and it's notated by usually capital letters, represents an outcome that hasn't occurred yet. And there's some probabilities associated with its different outcomes and we can explore that variable. So let's talk about one way to explore that variable, that's through expected frequency. So if I were to play roulette 1,000 times, each time betting $100 on black, how many times would we expect black to win? Well, we expect to get black 48.6% of the 1,000 times we play. So we can just multiply those. 48.6% of 1,000 means times 1,000. That's 486 times. So let's test this out through simulation and see if our probabilities are accurate. Right here on my computer, I have a simulation that I ran just this morning using a computer generator of a roulette game. And we're going to play it 1,000 times and see how many times we get a black win. So I'm going to go ahead and press auto, and it's going to generate different roulette spins. Each time that you see a number on the far left side, that's a black square that I got in. On the right side is a red square that I got in. So it's going to do it many, many, many times, and I'm going to speed it up. Every now and then, you will start to see a green space, that zero space. Let's see if we can get one of those greens here. There's one. There's two. So every now and then, one out of 37 times, roughly, we will get a green space. And then we're going to speed this up until we get to 1,000 plays. And give it a second here. You can already see some of the tallies going on here. I'm going to show you a breakdown at the very end that will show you the exact numbers from our game. There we go. That's 1,000 plays. And now if we look at the stats that we got, we see that we had exactly 486 black wins, which means that the ball, the virtual ball, landed on black squares 486 out of 1,000 times. So these probabilities and expected frequencies can be pretty accurate. So now let's move from expected frequency to expected value or expected winnings or losses from a game. So if I were to play 1,000 times, what would my average winnings be per play of the game? So I'm expected to win 486 times out of 1,000, and I'm expected to lose about 514 times out of 1,000. So if I multiply that by 100 for every time I win, because I win that much per play, or negative 100 for every time I lose, because that's how much I lose per play, I would get $48,600 in winnings, but about $51,400 in losses. Combine those together, you get a net loss of $2,800. This is my expected winnings, quote unquote, because it's actually a loss after 1,000 plays. So the average winnings, quote unquote, per play, if you divide that by 1,000, is about $2.80 lost. So this brings us to expected value. Expected value is the average value of a chance process after repeating many trials. The expected value of roulette is a loss of $2.80 when you put $100 on black or $100 on red. And the way we interpret this is after many trials, the average winnings for roulette is actually a loss of $2.80 per play. So that interpretation is really key. It's not the expected value from one play, it's after many trials, the average expected gain or loss. So note that losing $2.80 is not a possible outcome for one spin. From one spin, the roulette table, we're either gonna gain 100 from our bet or lose 100. The expected value tells you the average gain or loss over many trials, not from one single trial. So the way we calculate the expected value directly rather than doing the expected frequency is to weight the outcomes by the probabilities through multiplication and then add together to get the expected value. Let me show you one example. Say you play a coin toss game and heads means that you get $100, tails means that you lose $100. Find the expected value. We're going to assume this is a fair coin. That means that we get $100 for heads. We lose $100 for a tail, there's a 50% chance of each one. So we're going to find X here as a random variable with these outcomes. To get the expected value of playing this game, we weight the outcomes by the probabilities. So we're going to multiply the $100 positive outcome by the 50% chance it had. We're going to multiply the $100 negative outcome by the 50% chance it had. And we're going to add those weighted outcomes together. We get $0. This is a fair game. It means that we get plus 50, minus 50, we average up to zero. The expected value from this after many trials is an average of $0 gain or loss. Now say, let's modify this game a little bit. Heads means you get $300 and tails means you only lose 100. Find the expected value of this game. Well, now the heads has a higher value for winning. So when we multiply those probabilities by the values and we weight them, we actually come out ahead in this game on average because the winning was a higher value than the loss. So on average, this many times, we're going to average $100 of value gain per play. So that means that higher positive values tend to lead to higher expected values. That's a pattern to notice there. Now let's do a different version. Say the coin is now weighted. So there is a 75% chance of tails, it's an unfair coin. And let's go back to the original value. So a heads means you get $100, a tails means you lose $100, find the expected value. Well, now we have 100, 100, but the probabilities are in favor of the tails. And so when we weight those outcomes by the probabilities, there's more weight given to the negative outcome because it happens more often on average. So our expected winnings or losses on average for many trials would be about $50 lost. So the higher probability of a negative value leads to a lower expected value. That's the pattern to notice there. And then finally, one last example. Say the coin is weighted, so there's a 75% chance of tails, but the heads gets 300 now and the tails loses 100, find the expected value. When we do this weighting process of the values by the probabilities, we have a higher probability of a loss, but the lower probability win has a higher win value and they average out to zero. So on average, you expect $0 per play in this game. So that's the weighting effect there you can see through this example. In this case, it was all balanced out. So let's do that one more time with roulette, specifically at the casinos. We found the probabilities before. The probability of winning if you bet on black was 48.6%, the probability of losing 51.4%. You find the expected value by multiplying those probabilities by the value you would get or lose. You get a loss of $2.80 per game, as we found before. These probabilities, this expected value, is also the same for betting on red, because for betting on red, there's 18 out of 37 red chance of winning, but then there's the 18 black plus the one green space chance of losing. And that, again, outweighs, and you lose $2.80 on average per game if you do this many times. Now, the expected loss, therefore, for playing 1,000 plays is $2,800, as we saw before, which means the expected casino profit from 1,000 plays is a positive $2,800, because every dollar that you lose, the casino gets, and that's why they have roulette there. Now, individuals don't have many trials. You may play three or four times. So yeah, you might come out ahead, but on average, if you do this many times, you will lose on average. So the casino knows about expected value and they make their money based on these long run expected values because they are in the long run. They have many plays at their casinos per day. So they profit from those negative expected values for you because it's a positive expected value for them. And it's all because of that pesky green space. That pesky green space adds the probability to the negative side if you bet on black or if you bet on red, because it always goes to the opposing side, because no one would be crazy enough to bet on green because it's such a small probability. So that is what's killing you in these casino games. So let's return to my Las Vegas trip, and I'm going to tell you the story of what I, the statistician, did. I bet $0 on games, and so I walked away with a $0 net gain or loss because I was too smart to play at the casinos. Now, the house, the casino, did pretty well because our losses were their gains, and so they made $515. They used that negative expected value for us in the long run to do their bidding, and the house always wins. That's where this phrase comes from. The casinos tend to win. Now, when an individual has a gambling addiction, they play these games very, very often, and then that long-run expected value kicks in, and they tend to lose money. And there's a lot of science behind why people fall into a gambling addiction and how it can be so devastating. If you find that you are gambling to an extent that is unhealthy, or gambling to an extent where you're losing money, please, please do reach out to the National Council on Problem Gambling. They have a 24/7 toll-free hotline, call, text, chat. Please, please do reach out. So let's get into our discussion question for today. This is a good game. What I mean by that is that the expected value might actually be something that you might be interested in playing. So let's take this scenario. Imagine that casinos didn't take AP stats. They didn't really figure out about expected value. And so they come up with this game for high rollers. You roll a six-sided dice one time. If that dice comes up with a five or a six, you get $1,000,000, a great outcome. But if you roll a one, two, three, or four, you have to pay $300,000 to casino. My question for you is, would you play this game if you could play it only once? Why or why not? Calculate the expected value and please mention that in your answer. That's it for today, statisticians. Have a good one.